He was a former executive director at Hardy Gold Mines. So this project, largely by Dr. Prabhakar and from IIMA, Meenal and Kapil, they assisted in terms of getting the data through secondary research. On to Prabhakar.
I'm very much thankful to IIMA and IGCP for giving me this opportunity. Gold mining industry is a very, very interesting industry. Our mining dates back to more than 2,000 years. Mining in the early part of the 16th century is a second period, and modern gold mining activities commenced around 19th century, around 1889 onwards, regular mining activities. This is the one big data bank. We are carrying out an intensive exploration. During the exploration, we are generating the diamond drilling data, the core we are getting it. That core data will be having then information for which we can say that one, how the metal today, it may be the gold. Tomorrow, our metallurgy will advance. We may get a copper, we may get lead and zinc, we may get atomic minerals. All these studies can be carried out by storing this diamond drilling cores. This type of libraries has to be established and carried out to be further studies also. Because some of the mines like Kolar, I'll tell you, it is closed down now. Way back when the gold rate was very less, now the gold rate is very well, very good. Now to re-examine that one, earlier this data bank is not available. This is the one of the major work one has to carry out like this one. This is the one of the core library which was established by me. So this is an Indian geological map of geological survey of India map. Almost gold occurs in the every state of the country. The exploration has been carried out by the Geological Survey of India, Mineral Exploration Corporation, and other government and private agencies also. Gold occurs in almost in every state. This is the geological map of Karnataka. Major gold occurrences in Karnataka are, one is in the Kolar gold mine, and another one is in a Hatti gold mine. This is the Kolar gold mine, which was closed. Now the existing, only the producing gold mine is in Hatti gold mine is here. The gold mineralization took place in a various geological formations. Gold occurs in the quartz veins and like a loads and all those things. That is like a Hatti and Kolar. Another one, the gold occurs in the granulated terrain, which you can see that in Kerala, in Wayanad, Nilambur, India, Lar. And gold occurs in the banded iron formations. Gold occurs with the volcanogenic polymetallic sulfides also. Gold occurs in the quartz pebble conglomerates. Gold occurs in the placers and river beds also. Exploration is a very risky business. Only the exploration success will be 1:1,000. So now our exploration, whatever we have carried out and all the things was only a shallow level, up to a 200, 300 meter depth only. All the gold deposits, what we have observed so far, gold, copper, lead and zinc, are now all deep seated. For that thing, we have to carry out advanced exploration techniques. For these things, we are using the Halliburton survey and we are successful in establishing the good gold deposits. So this is the data which by Halliburton survey and subsequently how in the subsurface we have established the gold ore reserves. This is the diamond drilling data and carrying out the diamond drilling and preserving of this valuable information and data. So coming to the Kolar gold mine, this is then BGML was an established as a public sector in 1972. It was due to the non-economic viable, it was closed down in the 2001. The gold bearing loads, which was about 8 kilometer long, if you cumulatively keep it, all those things, all the drives and crosscuts, whatever the development has been carried out, it was about 1,647 kilometers. About 55 shafts were there in that area. You'll be surprised that when about 35,000 employees were there in the Kolar gold mine. At present, it has been closed. Now, big tailing dump is that one. That tailing dump, we have to see that one, whether we have to recover the gold from that, the Kolar gold mine or not. For this thing, lot of studies have been carried out, whether it can be used for the ceramic industry, agriculture sectors, or road metal, and all those things, studies are in progress. Whereas recovering of the gold and other metals are not possible. So this is the Hatti Musky schist belt map. in this area, a lot of the gold deposits have been identified. This is the Hatti mine is here, Uti is here, another Sidabuddi is here. All these gold deposits have been identified, and this can be worked as a satellite gold mine to increase the gold production. For this thing, statutory clearance works are in progress in the government level. This is a mechanized underground mining method, where earlier all the mining activities have been carried out by the laborers. Now intensive labor activities were there. Now it has been completely mechanized and machineries have been utilized to increase the production. So we can see that one geological setup of the India and Australia is same. Whereas there the production is more, where our Indian production is less. That one we have also established now a lot of the reserves. We have to increase our gold production here. So looking ahead, that one total gold resources of the gold metal in the established were about 585 tons. The available literature and other geodata has to be re-examined and re-evaluated. The exploration strategy of the gold in India need to be reworked out in the regional level, district level, and ore deposit skills. Although understanding of the local geological factors is very important. Exploration and mining industry is suffering from the shortage of the skilled manpower. Only skilled manpower forces can be increased, and also health and safety of the worker should be taken care. However, recently it has been addressed again. So these are all the R&D activities has to be carried out to investigate the new gold deposits, like this one, structural control, nature and composition of the gold-bearing fluids, evolutionary stages of the greenstone belts, and other aspects has to be studied out. By that one, we can establish the more gold ore reserves, which can be bring to the production immediately. So this is an we have to attract the foreign investment in a gold mining, which will increase the our gold production and will boost up, because a lot of investment is required in the gold mining, especially to bring from the exploration stage to the production stage. Especially many of the foreign companies have been interested in this one. By that one, our technology will improve and investment will be more. By that one, employment opportunities will increase. Effective tax rates, especially taxation, we have got a lot of the variation in the taxation. The taxation should be uniform. Especially this taxation, ETR does not cover the following, especially auctioning prices and purchase of the land, GST 18% on the royalty, and especially 10% tax is levied in the Supreme Court order of Karnataka. And net value, this one, for 4.38 lakhs to the, it has been increased to 10.43 lakhs per hectares, and especially afforestation works and all. And this was mining leases for permanent security and all is being increased. Especially ETR and mining comparison with ETR and mining companies of royalty, contribution to district mineral fund, national mineral trust, besides the GST rate. ETR and mining rates in India is high. It ranges between 60% to 40%. Mining sector wishes to have one tax regime seeking about around 40% capping. Having a single tax rate will help to reduce in the net ETR. State or region-wise, taxes should be abolished. And tax holiday can act as an incentive in an initial stage of exploration and production. Rationalization of royalty of the mines can also serve as a catalyst. So we have established so far our gold ore reserves. We have got huge gold ore reserves. About 503 million tons of gold ore have been established. During 1894, the production of gold in Karnataka was about mainly the gold production has came from Karnataka, that's why I'm mentioning Karnataka, 5.3 tons, when the CL gold price was only at 2 rupees 50 paisa per gram. The production was stepped up to reach the peak production of 14.7 tons in the year 1906. The present production is around only 2 to 2.5 tons per year. The best time is now available for stepping up of the gold exploration as well as production to enjoy all, because the gold rate is very good, enjoying all the time market. About 585 tons of gold metal established by the government and private agencies should be upgraded by substantial drilling, exploratory mining and feasibility studies to reach the mineable reserve. For this thing, the big process of exploration discovery and developing and establishing the new gold mines in the country should receive a serious consideration at all the level of decision making. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Dr. Prabhakar. Also to add there, the MMRDA, which mandated the auctioning of mines, has to go through a different process, due to which many of the explorers, although they got the reconnaissance permit, they're not allowed to mine because they did not have the permission. So those are the other regulatory aspects that needs to be taken care. And any questions?
Regarding the refining, mining and refining, both are done by the IT?
No, sir. We are now only doing the gold refining, we are not doing. Refining, that proposal is there, it will be established in future. Only bullion gold is.
No, you are a more than 100 years old company.
No, correct. You are correct, sir. That is under the consideration. Proposal is there. Definitely, it will be considered. It is one of the objectives.
Gold, mining and refining happens in the same place. So, until a year back, Bangalore refinery was refining at the gold mine. Now,
establishing. We are establishing that one.
No, Haiti is having a library of gold ores. And this type of, fundamentally you are very strong, we are not going for the refinery. What is the regulations problem or political problem or problem?
No, there is no problem, sir. We are only bound up on the main business of the exploration and mining and metallurgy. There is a proposal is there, we are doing it, we are establishing it, sir.
Okay.
Sir, just some clarificatory questions. Kolar, you mentioned a 16-kilometer long
drive. Yeah, sir.
And you also mentioned that there was a champion load
below,
which
is
not yet tapped.
Yeah.
Is there an estimate for the amount of gold that may be available as reserves in the Kolar, which is
untapped? Sir, it is an established. The ore reserves are available, sir. Very good question you asked, sir. The ore reserves available is about 16 million tons of the ore reserves are available, because when that mine was closed
at 3%.
It is around 2.5 to 3%, sir.
Okay.
3 grams per ton, it is available. The major drawback now is that one, the old data of each level, like 1-1 level, 30-meter level, it has gone up to, mine has gone up to 3 kilometer. That data has not been preserved properly. If that data is available in those old data, up to 3 kilometer depth, each level, that would have been computerized and digitized. Now would have been recasted on the present rate of the gold. So that would have been more helpful now.
So I'm just trying to get a sense of the available gold over there still.
Yeah.
Yes, we are not talking about feasibility, just a sense of the available gold. So if you're saying 1.6 million tons at 3%, that means 160,000 tons?
160,000 tons
of gold.
Yeah, sir.
That's 1%.
Yeah.
That sounds a bit too much.
Now the problem is that when it has gone up to 3 kilometer depth, mining at that level and all, safety of the mine and all is collapsed now. Only thing at the shallow level and adjacent areas can be thought of.
What is your estimate of what is recoverable still over there?
Still that recoverable is only about 30%, sir.
30%.
Only shallow level we can mine it. Because deeper level all is collapsed. It has gone up to 3 kilometer depth mine.
And the second thing you mentioned, there are 30 million tons of tailings.
Yeah, correct, sir.
What is the composition of the tailing?
The tailing is about, at the time, metallurgy was not advanced. So about tailing is having about 1 to 1.2% of the gold, grams per ton of the gold. For that thing, a detailed exploration has been carried out by the Mineral Exploration Corporation and the NMET scheme. In that one, the re-estimate, that one, it is about 0.8% gold is available, 8 grams per ton, that one. Now in that one, recovery will be but only 40%, sir. Remaining will not be possible. Second thing,
40% of 0.8 grams per ton.
Grams per ton, sir. Only recoverable. Remaining
0.3 grams per ton.
Yeah, sir. Now the question is, again, rehandling of the tailings. Here you will dump after the processing of that tailing again. Environmental clearance. And it is occupied more than about 500 acres of the land. Again, where you will put it. So only thing is that one, for that thing, whether it can be used in the agriculture sector or road metal, our ceramic industry. In that connection, a lot of research studies are going on at the Indian Institute of Science, at Central Road Research Laboratory, Delhi, and also in the University of Agriculture Sciences, sir, whether it can be used or all those things.
Okay.
Thank you.
Currently, the gold price is around 50. What is the mining cost for gold?
Good, sir, question. per gram of the gold production, I'll tell you per gram, it is now coming about the underground mine at Hatti, it is coming about a 2,600 rupees per gram production. Gram. What?
Okay, 2,600. Yeah, around $900. Yeah, that's.
That I'll share.
But definitely the government gets, when they sell this gold, they get a full duty, like they are getting almost 12.5% profit for these mines over and above whatever is. First, they are getting around 600 right now dollars per troy ounce. So
yes,
it is not possible with such kind of huge margin to explore much more of gold deposit in the country.
No, definitely it is possible, sir. A lot of the gold deposits have been explored and other things. Only thing, statutory clearance work is in progress. We have to get all the leases, number one. Number two, in the existing mine, mine construction is in progress because we have to go mine kilometers together down, mine kilometers together and level development. For that, mine construction itself is an exploration. That work is in progress. So, like an example, I'll tell you, Hatti gold mine is there. If we are now at gold, at present it is producing about 2 tons of the gold per year. It can go up to 5 tons of the gold per year, and that mine can survive for the another 100 years. That much of gold reserves have been established by utilizing this strategy of a gold rate. Now, considering the gold rate is very good, they are only mining now the low grade ore. High grade ore has been stocked now, stopped out.
So, but can't we now revive the Kolar
mine? No, say problem is reviving up the Kolar is a big question. That mine has gone 3 kilometer depth.
Okay.
All the underground levels have been full of water and the things, shafts have been collapsed and all those things. The revival strategy and all is in thinking, sir, government.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Can I add a point to the previous presentation? Not related to this this presentation. I would like to add 2 points. One is regarding the capacity utilization of gold refineries. It is directly related, and the growth of the refining industry is directly related to the government policies. Earlier under the 80-20 regime, there was a sudden growth of refineries. Some 20 new refineries came up just because there was huge profit margins under the 80-20 regime. The moment that was over, that benefit was not there, some 50% of the refineries closed down. Again, there was a 2% excess duty benefit for those refineries operating in excess-free zones like Uttaranchal. The moment the GST came and that excess duty benefit was withdrawn, the remaining out of the remaining refineries, another 50% came down. So presently, the capacity utilization and the number of refineries operational are very minimum. Even though there are 28 BS licensed refineries, I think hardly 50% of them are operational. Out of the 50% that are operational, 25% is depending on domestic scrap and 25% is depending on dore. That's about the capacity utilization. It is not just about the availability. It is about the government duty benefits, locational advantages and other things. Then the second thing is about the role of aggregators. The presenter has mentioned, I didn't add at that time. The role of aggregators is not basically of financing the mining output from the small artisanal mines. Their role is actually to mobilize smaller quantities of dore from small artisanal mines. See, like small artisanal mines are of 25 acres and all that. Their daily production is around 200 grams, 100 grams, 50 grams like that. Suppose I want a 25 kilo to 50 kilo consignment from Ghana, then I cannot go to each and every small mine. I have to mobilize 25 kilos. I have to go to hundreds of mines. So I depend on these aggregators. These aggregators' role is to go to each and every small faraway mines. They collect 50 grams, 100 grams. They, in a day, they'll mobilize for me. They will mobilize 50 kilos. So their role is mainly aggregating the smaller quantities from the artisanal mines. Funding is a different aspect. I may be funding, I may be giving advance financing to the aggregator, that's a different question. But basically it is the minimum quantity, the smaller quantities from artisanal mines, that is giving a role for the aggregators in the dore supply chain.
Sir, I...
Yeah, okay. That is there.
Sir.
No, in South America, the quantities are much bigger. The South American mines, the quantities are much bigger. So there, instead of these aggregators, there are local refineries. So from smaller mines, the materials come into the local refineries where they do some smelting, and then it is made to a bigger lot. So everywhere except for the big captive mines, these small and medium refineries are always dependent on some export house or aggregator, whatsoever name you call it. There are people who are mobilizing quantities. So to get 50 to 100 kilo per day for one refinery in India, you need to depend on this type of aggregators. See, the USA company is different. I don't want to go into the details. It is by a single refinery in India who have got captive arrangement. The source is USA, but it is not from artisanal mines.
Can I just ask a question on mining?
Basically, small, medium scale refineries cannot finance mining companies. A medium scale, like we said, 20 tons or 30 tons capacity, we have it. We actually try to finance a mining company, we lost money because there's no tracking. How do you control a mining company which is producing gold and reporting every day to you? So it's very difficult, so we have to have an intermediate people who can actually collect gold and supply to us. Only thing, the government policy mandates that we should have a mining company certificate. Instead of that, yeah, so that is another bottleneck we have it. As a refiner, we can't import gold actually from the mining company because they don't produce so much of gold which we require to fulfill our capacities.
Yeah. Can I just ask a question on mining?
Yes, sir.
One of the things you said is FDI in mining.
Yeah.
You went to this line. Yeah. And 100% FDI allowed, etc. But one understanding we got from many other thing is that the whole policy on mining is very unclear, which is why nobody wants to come. It's not about the effective tax rate alone.
Yes, sir.
It is also about the fact that if somebody comes, they have to spend a lot of money to find out that there is gold, prospecting.
Correct, sir.
They may take 5 years. And after that, the government doesn't give license to them to mine.
Correct, sir.
They will say, now it has to put up to auction.
Correct, sir.
Now, is that the main hindrance for development of mining here?
Definitely, sir. Definitely. One of the thing many, I will tell you, exploration to mining, lot of gestation period it is taking.
Yes.
Gestation period it is taking. We'll explore, then after exploration, we are applying for the prospecting license or ML from RP, and there it is taking, sometimes government policies are changing, they are going for the auctioning. At the time, the explorer will say that one, we have explored it and we are losing it. By that one, this is one of the reason why it is entering the...
Sir, one more quick question.
Definitely, sir.
Is Hatti very profitable?
Very much profitable, sir.
Then why isn't the government actually doing it? Doing this mining itself on all the other areas? After all, Geological Society has found out that there is gold.
Geological Survey of India. Huh?
Yeah, why a geological survey? But why is it that the government itself is not putting money and developing other mines? Why can't they replicate Hatti in every place that there is gold?
Yeah, sir, now the government, Hatti Gold Mines or some government agencies, all Geological Survey of India are doing intensive explorations. The explorations are at shallow level. I told you that Heliborne Survey is also carrying out. All the exploration has been carried out and we have applied for the leases. I have shown you that one. If government gives the leases or sanctions, then mining will start, sir.
It's not giving license to itself.
Sometimes it is not giving, though we are asking. Under, I'll tell you, sir, Hatti Gold Mines comes with the being the under 17-2A Act, MMRD Act. Then there is a lot of license clearance right from panchayat to parliament. Right from panchayat to parliament. To bring, I'll tell you, one mine from hammering of the first sample to the first ton of the gold production, it takes minimum 30 years. If today one person start his career as a geologist, takes one hammer, to become a owner of that mine, agent, like me, that one minimum 30 years. This is my experience, right? Started as a geologist and ended as executive director. I've seen it, struggling hard, day by day. What happened? We have explored. I thought I was confident that one, I'll get my leases. Now they were telling that one, I'll put you into the action. So certain these things have to be streamlined, sir. Thank you. Yeah, sir.
Thanks. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.